Hey, this is SGU, and welcome back to my Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim franchise mode series here in MLB The Show 17 on the PS4. Now, we are into, our fifth episode today, starting off the month of May with a series against Seattle. Will we play any of these? No. Well, yes, actually, as we sim forward, we are going to have a critical situation, and it is a chance to, well, hopefully avoid a walk-off by the Mariners. Our closer, Cam Bedrosian, who has been a little bit rocky and is not in a save situation here. He's just trying to keep this game alive. He gets the strikeout, and with a 1-2 count, freezes him with the slider. So a couple strikeouts to make sure the Mariners do not walk it off, at least in this inning. And he shows a little bit of emotion right there. Fist up in the air. Let's watch the split screen. And Bedrosian spins around and fist pumps right there as he knows he's done his job. Let's see if Mike Trout can come through. Already a home run in this game. Obviously the corner piece of our franchise. We discussed his value out in the open market, the trade market, a couple episodes ago, but he's staying put for the foreseeable future. Want to build around this guy, not get pieces for him that may never pan out or amount to anything in the majors. We have a bona fide superstar on our hands here in Mike Trout, and he comes through again here with a double. Hopefully we can bring him around to score. Ben Revere, former Minnesota Twin, gonna line that one to right, down for a hit. Trout is coming, relay, he gets around the tag. So an aggressive base running decision pays off. Ben Revere has his RBI and the Angels have the lead. Can they close it down? Bedrosian still in the game. He's in line for a win now. Doesn't happen too often for closers. Either they're getting a save or they're getting a loss because they've blown it. But he has a chance for a win in the 10th inning, and oh, he gets the call in the corner with the slider. Yeah, not very fond of that call, but it's strike three and the game's over. The Angels win it in extras. So that one feels good right there to eke it out on the road. 3-2 victory. Like I said, Bedrosian gets his first win of the season. Mike Trout's your player of the game. Hits a homer in this as well as a double to get the late rally going. So we win 2 of 3 in Seattle. That's good. We're in first place. That'll keep us there by doing that. We lose 2 of 3 against Houston, who was struggling. They're not having the awesome start that they are in real life. Man, how about those Houston Astros right now? Anyway, our critical situation is protecting a lead here against Oakland. It's 4-3, and well, just like that, no mess. We get the thing done. Ball game over. And Bedrosian, after getting that win, now collects another save. Angels win on the road, this time in Oakland Coliseum. Mike Trout, surprise, surprise, again, your player of the game with another home run. Should we talk about unfortunate things? How about Mike Trout in real life breaking his thumb? Going to miss, a month and a half? And the Angels can't catch a break. He was red hot, scorching hot coming out of the gates this year in real life. So we're on to the series against Detroit here. We're going to go ahead and quick manage to start off. And, well, maybe we regret that as we give up a 5 spot in the first. But we're going to come crawling back here. 5-3 now. Make it 5-4 and a single and a run scored. Detroit comes back with a sacrifice fly, makes it 6-4. We got a runner at third. Let's squeeze him home. Yes, it works. It's a 6-5 game, and I'm going to take over in the ninth. We got one more chance here. 2-2 count with one out, and Escobar's going to get a base hit. It drops just in front of the left fielder, so we got a runner on, and we've got a chance. Can we make something out of it? Well, let's find out here. First of all, Mike Socha's got a decision to make. Does he pinch run? Yep, Ben Revere comes in the game. He's on the bench, and he's perfect for this situation. Speediest guy on our roster. Okay, Cole Calhoun. We've talked about his struggles early in the season. He got it working a little bit, and then, again, not so much. That ball is taken, and that is a steal for Ben Revere. He's now in scoring position. Calhoun continues his struggles as he pops up on the infield, and now there are two outs. So the runner is still in scoring position, but we need to find a way to bring him home. Well, what do we got next? It's Mike Trout to the rescue. Hopefully he's 1-for-3 with a single, but he's got a chance to keep this game alive. Let's see if he can do it. A 1-1 count with two outs. The pitch, it's lined over the glove of the shortstop and down for a hit, sending Revere to the plate, and he will score without a throw. We are tied at 6, and Angel Stadium is rocking. I don't know, do they still do the rally monkey out in Anaheim? I haven't been there in a while since, actually, the only time I've been to Angel Stadium was 2004 when they took on the Red Sox in the playoffs. Oh, by the way, did I say I'm a Red Sox fan? You guys know I'm a Red Sox fan. I got to see the start of the magical 2004 playoff run in person. Game one in Anaheim Stadium. It was Curt Schilling on the mound. He got injured that day. That was the start of what would lead to the bloody sock later in the playoffs. And the lore of that, oh my goodness, that's got to be up there for Web Jam of the Year. This looked like a sure base hit and really put us in a good spot to get a run in extras and win this thing. But look at this insane effort. Are you kidding me? Robs what it would be, like I said, a sure hit. He makes an excellent play. And now with one out in the 10th, the next thing you know, we're rolling into a double play. So how huge was that play at third base? And it keeps this game alive through 10 innings. We go to the 11th now. And a bit of a problem as there are two runners on and two outs, and Cameron Maben is able to track that one down for out number three. Looked a little scary, but he's able to get there. So Mike Trout, often a hero, comes up 2-for-4 with two singles. He could send everybody home with a long ball or even something into the gap. 3-2 with two outs, and he strikes out. Oh, no. Thought we were going to have a Mike Trout moment, but it didn't happen there. On to the 12th inning. Strike three. Huge second out right there as there are runners at the corners with only one out. And now we got two outs and a 1-2 count. Can he work his way out of it? Strike three. Swinging high and outside of the zone, but he chased after it. What a job right there getting out of a jam. And once again, we will play another inning, or at least go to the bottom of the 12th, that is. Angels fired up, the crowd's fired up, but hey, we've gone into the 14th inning now. We're playing a lot of free baseball. This is foul territory. Calhoun might not be hitting, but he does chase this down. He's got an 0-for in this game going that, well, it's got to be really frustrating. He's dropping down near 200 with his average. We'll check on him in a little bit. But 15th inning, Cameron Maben. Did he hit it? This is often deceptive, this angle. Every time it goes up in the air, I'm like, did he hit it out? Nope, not even close. Caught in foul territory by Upton. And we are going on to even more free baseball. Still tied at 6-6. Let's throw it in now. Like I said, Cole Calhoun, 0-for-7 at this point. I mean, an 0-for is bad, but you go into the 16th inning, 0-for-7, and, well, it's going to be 0-for-8 as they throw him out. Cole Calhoun, definitely one of the people that just wish this game would end already. It's been a disaster for him. We go to the 17th inning, bottom of the 17th, runner in scoring position. Maben hits it hard. Get down for a hit. It could be ball game. No, it stays up and it's caught. We're going to play on through the 17th. Where are we going to pick it up now? 18th inning, top of the 18th. Detroit has two runners on, and they're bunting them over. Good bunt right there. Fielded the toss over to first base. Nice and easy, but you've got two runners in scoring position now and only one out. We are going to issue an intentional walk. Surprised we can't just signal it in the new game here now this year, because that's what's going on in real life. Maybe they'll simulate that next year. Anyway, bases loaded. One out. In on the corners on our defense, but we get the strikeout. Not even put in play. Oh my goodness, that is huge, because now we have two outs. We can drop the corner infielders back, and this one hit the second. Can he make the play? Spinning, throwing, yes. Yes, we kept them off the scoreboard. Parker works out of a jam. It's still 6-6. We are going to the bottom of the 18th inning. Nothing happening there, and poor Cole Calhoun in the bottom of the 19th inning. Now we've fast-forwarded. He's 0-for-8. He's got a 2-2 count, works along at bat, but then rolls one to second. He's now 0-for-9. Poor Cole Calhoun. It's just not working out. Trout, 2-for-7. Another chance to be the hero. In the bottom of the 19th with one out. What? He didn't swing there. Are you kidding me? Check swing. Come on. That was ridiculous. Two outs now. Pujols puts a charge in one. Did this end the game? No. It's staying in play. And we are going to a 20th inning. Can you believe it? This is absolutely insane right here. We've played more than the equivalent of two games now as we go to the 20th inning. Two outs, 3-2 count, strike three. Okay, another chance to end this thing if we can just get one run. Let these people go home. And yet, that's not the case. We don't score in the 20th. It's on to the top of the 21st inning. Ground ball the second. Throw to first base. out. And is that the inning? Yes, it is. We will go to the bottom of the 21st inning. I mean, is there a curfew? I mean, this is on the West Coast. What time would this game be going on at right now? I mean, if you're on the East Coast, is this like 6 in the morning at this point? I mean, it's got to be crazy. Anyway, we're not scoring in the bottom of the 21st. Let's take it to a 22nd inning. I can't believe I'm even saying that. Top of the 22nd. One on, two out, strike three. I think that's Cam Bedrosian in the game once again. We ran out of bullpen. We'd have to go to starters if we take anyone else out of the game. And we don't really want to do that. So Cole Calhoun, I mean, could he turn that 0-for-9 into 1-for-10? I don't know. Let's see. Nope. He's going to ground out to second base again. Cole Calhoun is 0-for-10 in this game. I mean, just what do you got to do when you're struggling? Anyway, Mike Trout, 2-for-8. We've been in this spot how many times tonight, this morning, whatever it is.
Set to deal on 2-2. A drive to left. Get out of here. Get out of here. Gone. They win it. Santa Maria. It's a solo home run here for Mike Trout. And with one swing of the bat, this ball game is over.
Hey, when you get into extra innings, you're always looking for that one guy to step up and be that hero. And this guy was the hero tonight. What does he do? Steps up with a walk-off home run to end this thing in extras.
Holy smokes, it took forever and a day, but Mike Trout eventually is the hero that walks us off in the bottom of the 22nd inning. What a marathon. Too bad it doesn't count as two wins as we walk it off and beat the Detroit Tigers. Your player of the game with 3 hits and 9 at-bats, Mike Trout, hits the game-winning home run. He got us here into extras. He's responsible for this marathon game as he singled home that run in the bottom of the 9th as well. So a 7-6 Angels victory. We've now won 3 in a row, getting back into things here, still in this Tiger series, and a player lock milestone. My goodness, Garrett Richards throwing a perfect game right now through 6. Okay, most of the times they throw me into this scenario, I give up a hit like in the first or second batter. Let's see how I fare this time. Strike 3. He's got one out in the 7th inning. Okay, our team ERA looking good at the top of the American League at 2.72. Let's keep it that way. Richards dealing 0-2 to the next batter. Strike 3 on the slider. Upton can't make contact. 2 outs in the 7th inning. Can he make it a clean 1-2-3 again? Remain perfect. Strikes out the side. Another slider. This time Miguel Cabrera swings and misses. And he's on to the 8th inning with the perfect game. I think all the nation turning in now on MLB Network or wherever they can catch it to see if he can finish it off. The Angels get 2 more runs in support, and it's all him now, 4-0. Strike 3 looking. 1 out in the 8th inning. You see the line right there. Yes, indeed. No hits, no walks. It's a perfect game right now. 1-2 count with 1 out. Oh, my goodness. Look at him dropping that curveball. Nothing you can do about that filth. He's going to ask where it was, but yeah, you got to walk back to the dugout and tip your cap right there. 2-0 count. Uh-oh, this is a little scary, but he gets a fly ball. Okay, stay in the park. Yes, make the catch. Yes, he's through 8 innings. Garrett Richards on alert now. Everyone tuning in to see the 9th if he can do it and make a little bit of history here tonight at Angel Stadium. 0-2 count to the first batter of the inning. And it's in play. Second base, a slow roller. Out number one. He's 2 away now. Garrett Richards. Could he pitch the perfect game? Everyone waiting to see what happens. 1-2 count. 1 out. He's got that one in the dirt. Swinging. Strike 3. Throw down to first base. Don't take your time. Oh, my goodness. That was a little lackadaisical throwing down there, but he gets the out. Number 2. Jacoby Jones. Only thing standing between Garrett Richards and a perfect game.
Chopped weakly to the left. Taken there by Escobar. Throw in time. He's done it. A perfect game.
Yeah, you've heard when it rains, it pours. Well, it was raining dominance out here in this one. 27 up, 27 down, and he barely broke a sweat half the time. That's one of the rarest feats in all of sports, and I'm just excited I was here to be a part of it. Perfection is always beautiful.
Oh my goodness, what an episode of franchise this has been. First a 22-inning walk-off, now a perfect game by Garrett Richards, 13 strikeouts in his gem, and he goes down in the history books. Quite excitement here in the first month and a half of Angels baseball, and this week especially. So, after all that, the Pirates are interested in offering us a trade. Let's see what they've got. They are offering up Ivan Nova for Cameron Maben. So we got to go ahead and investigate here. And I thought about doing this trade. I'm thinking about it. Nova's 30 years old. He's under contract for 3 more years. They're both averaging $9 million a year. So there's really no salary difference. There's really no player morale difference either, as they're both 77 or 78 and bumped to an 81 overall right now as you investigate further. Cameron Maben's a year younger, although his contract is expiring, which made me think about doing this deal. But in the end, I'm going to go ahead and decline this because I really don't know that a 30-year-old pitcher who makes our rotation but is not at the top end of the rotation is really what we need to be building on right now. We're going to keep Maben for now. So we take 2 of 3 against Detroit. The White Sox are up next. That series, as we sim forward, is going to be 2 out of 3. We're losing it, so that's not good. But anyway, interleague play when we come back. We get to take on the New York Mets at Citi Field and Jacob deGrom. They're 22-19. We're 26-17. Should be a good matchup. We'll see you next time for more Angels baseball.